Welcome, everybody. I know everybody was here for the Enjoy Board meeting. First, I'd like to introduce Lauren Wolf, who just got recruited to be my assistant. Unfortunately, Seth Parker's a name you will get to know. Seth is our new Comcast service account rep, but I don't know if it was the stomach flu or fear of showing up to 300 people that he couldn't make it tonight, so I'm it. But otherwise, Seth will be involved. Hey, I can't see him.
He heard I was coming.
Hey, does this work?
It's okay. We don't need you.
How about now?
Good.
Okay. You guys see?
No.
I'm out of the picture. All right, go ahead, Lauren. This is a Comcast overview. It's going to be quick because we all have subsequent meetings. Hit the down arrow. Hit it again. Technical difficulties, if not a good thing. Come on, right? I don't want to waste everybody's time, so I'm going to do it from memory. And then I will send out the presentation. If you give me just 1 minute, because I would like you to see some of these slides, but the laptop just froze, so I have a slightly another idea.
Ah, there it goes. Start from scratch, Jason.
One more. Okay, down next one. We'll go down. All right, we are going to get the highest level internet Xfinity package that is offered by Comcast. It's called the X1 platform. It's their brand new fiber optic platform that they are running all of their services over. Voice, internet, and TV is all coming over fiber. The good news is most of us are over the digging and the trenching. So congratulations to the team, and we're sorry for the interruptions. It's probably going to take 10 more days, and you won't see any more digging and repairs, hopefully around the community, and we will start to do the important stuff, which is change our services to a much higher level service. X1 involves all kinds of new activities, and if you go to the next slide. One of the most amazing things about X1 is its remote. The remote is fully integrated into the new system. It's got two interesting features. How many of you have a set-top box hidden in a cabinet, so you had to have order a special remote to go through the cabinet? That's called radio frequency. Those are usually an upgraded remote. This is a point anywhere remote. So anybody who wants to hide the remote behind the TV or underneath the cabinet can do so. It's a radio frequency remote. One of the most interesting features is this right here. This is what's going to solve a lot of the senior citizen angst. I go crazy looking at their guide, but now I don't have to. I push the button, I hold it, and I say football. I say Giants. I say Marlins. I say Netflix. I say Dolphins. I say baseball. It shows all those stations that are related to those words. If I want to say Netflix, how many of you have a Netflix subscription? That's almost 80%. How many of you have an appliance that you have to go through to get Netflix to work?
It's
gone. It's a special channel on Comcast. So all you have to do is hold the button, say Netflix. Doesn't mean the subscription is paid for. It just means you have direct access to it. So that's what all that means. Next. Now, this is very interesting. How many of you use YouTube for anything? How many of your kids live on YouTube? Does anybody know the largest streaming video service and music service out there? Is it Amazon, Apple, Pandora, or Spotify? Spotify, Pandora, YouTube. YouTube is the largest single venue for anything information right now. It is the largest purveyor of DIY. How do I fix my toilet? How do I do anything? And it also has hundreds of help things on Comcast. So you go right to YouTube. What is YouTube? You don't need an appliance. You go right to the special channel on Comcast and YouTube. You type in what you want to search for, and bingo, there it is. Also, you're going to have the direct thing with Netflix. Same thing. I don't think the Netflix app is voice controlled, but we'll see how close it is because it's changing. Next. This, for all you sports fanatics, has a special sports app. On this side of the screen, you can have live streaming NFL scores. You can have updates of baseball scores, NBA scores, your favorite team. You can program this to a zillion different options, and it'll give you all the sports simultaneously while you're watching whatever game on this side of the screen. So it's an automatic split screen. Very creative, very interesting. Next. This we've talked about a dozen times. We now have about 12 meg service. We're going up to 75 meg service. Means nothing to anybody other than the internet speed is going to be 6 times greater than we have now. Much more reliable, much more efficient due to the fiber network. And for those of you, anybody upload stuff to Facebook or photos or anything, and it takes forever, guess what? This now has a 10 meg upload speed, which is 10 times what we have now. So the ability to upload and use the services for your grandkids or yourself. Adrienne's not here, but a lot of the photography people, this will be here. Oh, she is here! That she will be able to use this person. Next. This is very neat. I did this last time. It comes with a phone. It does not come with these phones, but this is what most of us have in our house, portable phones. It does not come with the phones. It is a phone line. It involves unlimited national calling. Joel, we're sorry to lose you, but it does include France for like 3 cents a minute. And it has all kinds of fancy features, all of which you can either YouTube, Xfinity Voice, you can go online, and we'll be sending out some stuff to give you more details. But it has call forwarding, it has voicemail, it has the same thing on the TV that tells you who's calling. And I have this on my phone, which I really like. Every time I get a voicemail at home, it emails my phone, so I never check my home phone. It's either on my voice, it's on my mail, or I don't even bother with it. Next. This is very exciting. How many of you have something like a smart something? I have smart something other than a wife or a husband. Or a girlfriend or a boyfriend. So, you got a tablet, you got a phone, you've got anything. Guess what? It's very interesting. What Xfinity Stream means, there's an Xfinity app called Xfinity Stream. You can take your library of DVR shows with you, and you don't have to be on the Wi-Fi network in your house. You can look at various live TV shows. You can set up recordings. But the neat thing is, you can also download them to your iPad. So like if you're on an airplane or you're going to France, like one of our friends does all the time, he can have 3-hour movies for free and you'll pay $12. But this is a spectacular app. So you can stream, and you can also look at on demand. Now, they have hundreds of thousands of items on their inventory. Can you look at every one of them? No. Can you probably do about 80%? Yes, that should be more than enough to keep us busy when we're stuck at the airport or visiting the grandkids or going to the beach and just enjoying the day. But it's a phenomenal app. And then, when you come to our next meeting, I'm going to share a secret with you that even Comcast has released. Next. This is not for us yet, but they have a dedicated bulk center just like UVerse does. It's only for our communities. There's only several dozen communities right now that are set up to go to, where's the Fort Myers and Jacksonville? Yep, Fort Myers and Jacksonville. So we will be mostly dealing with onshore customer service people that know all about bulk services, and they will know our contract in detail. Next, please. I've already covered this. The reason you're seeing all the digging, trenching, and complaining, and I'm one of them, and we're doing well with it, is because we have to put fiber in the community. The fiber is the next gold standard. If you don't have fiber in your communities, you're not going to keep up with technology, the streaming options, or any kind of information exchange. I do this every time I'm up here. 5 years ago, how many people were really comfortable with their iPhones? A few. Or their Galaxy phones. Now, no one would give them up. Am I correct? Well, this is what's happening. If you don't have high-speed internet going into your house, guess what's happening to all the services? The TV, the phone, everything is over what? Internet. So if you don't have a high-quality, what they call pipe, you're not going to have high-quality services in your house. 4K is coming. How do you think Netflix is going to be running your 4K? They're going to be running over the fiber to your house at a very high bandwidth. If you don't have a big, fat, screaming pipe, you're going to get terrible reception. Well, we've sort of future-proofed what we have because we're putting fiber to every house, and that's why the unfortunate digging is going on. I have one interesting question, and I'm digressing. Someone said, geez, if we would have gone with AT&T or Hotwire, we wouldn't have to do this. Wrong. Hotwire and AT&T would be digging up the community, and they might be hiring the same subs. So the digging and trenching is unrelated to the vendor we chose. It's just the nature. They all have to do this. Next. This is the fun part. That was Seth's part, so you can give Seth a congratulations. He did that part. I just did it for him. Now here's the fun part. We are going to structure our installations, and they are going to start as soon as... Where's Larry? We hope, what is Monday, the 9th?
Yes.
We hope Monday the 9th, but at the latest, the Friday following the 9th. You will actually start to get an email from the cable committee by pod. So right now it looks like Morocco, I did this last time, and what is it, Avia Terrace and those two streets in there, pods D and E, it looks as if that D, yeah, D and E will probably be the first pods that will go. So only you guys will be getting emails that say call. Behind the scenes, you do not waste your time in calling, because they have something called credentials. If your house is not lit, and it's not a fire lit, it's like a code in the system, they won't even talk to you because you're not allowed to do anything. So please follow the guidelines. Only call when you are told. The next thing we're going to do, we'll send an email blast to each resident of that pod. We're also going to have Comcast send a flyer to every resident of that address when you can call. And thank you to Adrian, Ted, and Barry Bergen. We are also going to have a door knocker, similar to the paint committee, so we'll recruit some resident help to post a note on every resident's garage door that said it's time to call Comcast and set your install. Next. How do you set an appointment? We're going to give you a special Comcast number. You can also walk in to the location in the Del Rey Marketplace, or if you're Maxwell Smart, you just pick up your foot and not your phone, and you call the same number, and you'll get connected to Comcast. Also, on the 19th and the 20th, and I don't remember, but watch for the email, we'll be doing a three-hour on-site installation. Those are only for people who have been told that their house is ready. Hey, September 19th? Hey, what the heck? October 19th and October 20th. You can see I was a little sleepy when I did this before Yom Kippur. I was out of food. And anyway, so what's going to happen at that meeting, we're actually going to have Comcast people here. We'll answer a whole bunch of questions, and you can actually sign up for your installation. You can pick your date, and you can get all your questions answered while you sign up. It's not going to be a general information meeting. It's a specific meeting for those people that were on the previous slide. Your house is now ready for install. So we'll probably have 240 residents by the time, we may have even 400 residents by the time October 19th and 20th show up that are available for installation. And I have a personal favor. Everybody's heard about the digging and the trenching. We've had Irma. We've had some setbacks with construction time. I really need everyone. The minute you are able to set an install date, please call within 24 hours. We need to get everybody converted to Comcast. We're a couple weeks behind because of weather and structure. Please, everybody here, do everything you can. Also, it's more advanced services. You're getting more services for less money. What the heck? Who doesn't like something for free? Next. And don't forget Maxwell's Morning. How do you sign up for new services? You're going to call the special number that's going to be on your email blast or your garage door. There's a procedure that you go through, and I'm going to post this on the website, and I'll give it to Lauren to put in her minutes. You will actually call Comcast. They're going to ask you, are you a new or existing customer? You're a new customer. Are you calling about a home or business? You're calling about a home. Give them your zip code, tell them you want new service. An agent will get on the phone. That's when the fun begins. Now you will provide an address, Valencia Falls, and you're a new bulk customer. So that's the secret. So we will be putting this out, and I'll give it to you again. Please go ahead, next slide. Now, what happens on the call? You're going to give me your name, obviously. You're going to give them your home address. I'm going to slow down now. You're also going to give them your phone number. And this is where it's important. How many of you currently have what we call a landline? How many of you currently are using UVerse landline? How many have somebody else's landline? Anybody who has a current phone number, it takes 5 to 7 days to transfer your phone from X company to Comcast. That means if you are able to install by our pod node on Monday, I'm sorry, call and request an installation date on Monday, you couldn't get that install date till the following Monday. So that's why I need everybody's help, because not only do we have Irma and a construction delay, we have a 5 to 7 day delay to transfer phones. And how many here do not have a home phone? There's only about 20 people in the community that have gone without it. So we have another 5 day delay for almost every transition. So we're going to review, and there's additional services you can get. As I said, please set your installation date as soon as possible. I can't repeat enough. Please do it ASAP. This is important. You're going to, just how many people have an AT&T account? I do. How many don't use the AT&T account? I don't. You need a Comcast control account. Do not use that for your email. That's just to log in, to pay your bill on extra services, to see what's going on, to get all the free services. So when the agent comes, or they're on the phone, set up a Comcast email that you can remember, but that's your control email. It's not your communication email. It's just for Comcast. And I'm going to repeat this for the 27th time. Under no circumstances should anybody sign up for a Comcast email as their email. If you want an email, you don't like the one you have, go to Yahoo, go to MSN, go to Hotmail, go to anything but AT&T and Comcast, because right now they do work. Tomorrow they could shut off anybody that doesn't have their service. So do not go to Comcast as your regular email, just your account control email. And I want you to review the bulk services. This is very important, Warren. All right, what do we have? Because you might not know what you have. Basically, most of you are going to order no incremental services. Why? Because the package is so feature-rich. What are we getting? We're getting the full lineup of 260-plus, I think it's about 190 high-def channels. We're getting one high-def DVR that records 6 shows at one time. No different than we have now, except our recorder can only do 2 or 3 shows at one time. This one can do 6. We're going to have 2 additional full-service set-top boxes. No different than we have now. So basically, you're going to get a 3-box, box-for-box replacement. 1 DVR, high-def, and 2 additional full-service boxes. That's all we have right now. Then you're going to get 1 digital high-def adapter. That's great for a spare bedroom. It gets 90 channels, ESPN, Nat Geo, HGTV, believe it or not, ESPN, CNBC, Fox News, all the other news channels. So it's really almost a full-service 4th box, but it doesn't get things like On Demand or Showtime or HBO. Our package includes all the movie channels, HBO, Showtime, Cinemax, and I know I'm missing one, but it's everywhere. Stars. The only one it doesn't include is Epix. So that digital premiere package, and online I will be sending out later this week a full channel lineup. Remember, channel lineups change as often as, I don't want to use that example. Channel lineups can change frequently. So just because you get the lineup today doesn't mean it's going to be the lineup we get tomorrow. But it's going to be 99% the same. You're going to get the blast internet of 75 megs. You're going to get a full wireless internet modem and what they call the gateway. You're going to get a voice plan, and here it is. You get free calls to Canada, Mexico, Hawaii, and you got a whole bunch of other features. You also have Norton Security Suite. I've been advised by one of my technical friends, Mr. Grummet, that if you have Windows 10, you probably want to use the Microsoft antivirus and anti-phishing and firewall that comes with Windows 10 rather than Norton. But if you want the full Norton Suite, which retails for $149, Comcast will give it to you for free. And obviously it goes over to fiber network. Warren? Now this is the additional services. Right now these are my estimated prices. When you call, if you want an extra set-top box, it's about $10 a month. If you want another digital adapter, if you don't need your guests to have Showtime or HBO or On Demand, it's only $6. The sports package, which basically we have except for Red Zone, for the few months that you want to watch NFL and you want to watch the Red Zone, it's an add-on for $10 a month. MLB innings and NBA League Pass you can add on. There's already apps on the thing, so you don't have to buy a special appliance. Just go to the NBA or the MLB app. Pay your subscription like Netflix and bingo. You don't need a Roku or an Apple TV or Chrome to go right over Comcast. International stations, Israel, France, China, Latin America, they're all around $9 to $20 a month. Additional phone line, limited service, those of you that think you need a fax line or another fax line because the husband talks all the time and the wife wants a line, or vice versa, it's an extra $12. And if you want to upgrade, like a couple of us would like to, for double the internet speed, it's currently about $20 a month. So most of you will have a zero add-on bill except for special premium stations or shows you choose to watch. That's why you go back money for work. That's why I'm going to put out this so you know exactly what's in your package. And if you go to the next one, this one. So you can see that the add-ons are not very expensive. But for the most part, there's nothing you really need to add except maybe a set-top box because everything is included. Next.
Per month?
Per month. Those are all per month. And thanks to Ted and Adrian and Barry, this is your door knocker. Time to call. Installations are ready for Pod D. Call the special number. Tell them you're from Valencia Falls and your property address. Thank you. Questions? I'd like to do one other thing before Sid grills me. How many of you have called the office recently? Larry didn't mention one of his pet projects was he did a brand new phone system for the HOA office, brought it up to state of the art, provided expansive new services for the team, and allows them to work more efficiently. The difference is, now when you call, an auto attendant is going to answer. And all you just do is listen. It says, hi, you've reached Valencia Falls. Press 1 for receptionist, press 2 for standard, plus 3 for social director, press 4 for clubhouse manager, and press 5 for property manager. That's all you have to do. This allows the staff to work more efficiently. Instead of everybody answering 20 calls, they only have to answer the calls that are meant for them. With that, Lawrence, covered enough?
No, tell them that they're changing.
Now, people are a little nutty over this. Hello, you've reached Valencia Falls. We are currently unavailable. That was a mistake. We were supposed to take that out. Ignore that one. We're going to change the voicemail message to say, hi, this is Valencia Falls Clubhouse. Please press 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for your party. When? Probably tomorrow when I talk to Krista. No, I'm playing tennis. And then after that, I have lunch. And then after that, I have a date with my wife. So if it gets done by Wednesday, you want to say thank you. Sid,
what is in the 2018 budget for the school year?
No idea. No idea. We have to ask Larry or Joel. But I can tell you it's approximately, I can do that in my head, about 80,000 a month, which is 960,000, county taxes. Yes, sir.
It's not on. No.
Okay, go ahead, speak to the mic.
What's going to happen to the AT&T?
Okay, I put out a note today, or yesterday, on the website. The question was, and I'm going to repeat every question. What happens to the AT&T equipment? Great question. Right now, the rule is that each person will return it to the UPS store. They don't have to pay for a box. They don't have to pay for a box, and they will code it back to you. We are meeting with AT&T this month to try to figure out a more streamlined position. Interesting, I just found out last week that they have an entity called debulking, which means they know they're going to lose certain communities, so they have a team that handles the transitions from what was U-verse to something else. So stay tuned for the internet and information. We will explain how to return the equipment. But for right now, it's one-on-one. But hopefully in 2 weeks, we'll have a better answer. Yes, sir.
I have two questions. Oh, David Hagel's here. I have two questions. Number one, I presume that anything that we have recorded on the AT&T box we lose when we switch over to Comcast. Is that correct?
Question was, can you transfer your recordings from UVerse box to Comcast box? Unfortunately, the answer is you cannot.
The second question is, they have fiber going up to the house. What about inside the house up to what you call, I think, the gateway?
The question was, they have fiber going to the side of the house. What do they have going from that wall to the rest of the house? How many of you have ever looked at what's in your laundry room in that technology or electrical panel in there? That controls your whole house. And back in the day, coax cable is in there. Coax went to almost every room in the house, as did phone lines. Comcast is going to use those coax cables that go into those rooms. So it's going to be fiber to your house and then coax to the individual set-top box.
So does that change the size of the pipe, as you call it?
No, because they can still run a gigabit of service over the coax right now, and we're only at 75 meg, so you have plenty of capacity. Next question. Thank you. Oh, you're welcome. Yes, ma'am.
Is anything being done for people who will not be here when their pods are called? How will that be handled?
Our question is, what's going to happen to the people not in residence? I sort of addressed that in an email the other day.
That's not the question. Those who are going to be away temporarily for that time.
It's the same issue. You're not here, you're not here. But she said that if they're not, so if you're not here, but you know you're coming back, the question was, what about people that are not physically here when their pod is ready? You will still know the 800 number. If you're only gone for 2 or 3 weeks, call and set an appointment for a day or two after you come back. But I want to transition into the seasonal residents who may not come back for 6 weeks or 8 weeks. They're going to have the same issues. We're going to publish an email tomorrow telling them what the process is. But basically, UVerse does not expire until December 31st of this year. So you're all going to, if you don't want to have your thing installed until December 5th, and you want to have UVerse through to December 5th, it's not going anywhere. It's not going anywhere on December 25th and Christmas either. It's not going anywhere on 12/29 either. So anybody who is worried about not having service, it's not true. UVerse will be operational until 12/31, and probably they can't flip the switch that fast. So probably for a few days thereafter for people that haven't converted but don't. So the seasonal residents will have the same issue. We'll mail them by pod. What are we looking at? Where's Ted? Ted, what are we looking at? About November 5 for everybody to sort of be available. We're looking for about November 5. We think around November 5 to November 10, everybody will be getting a letter that says you can call now. So that's a great question. Yes, sir.
Hi, Harvey Finder here. Just a quick question. Is there any way to defeat channels? A lot of these, you know, $19.99 and plus, you can buy another one to just pay shipping and handling.
You know, I try that one more time.
Is there any way to delete channels that you don't want? There's so many channels that are.
The question is, and this is a very interesting question, can you delete channels? Comcast has a very innovative guide. It has the ability to set up a couple different types of favorites. So when you go through the guide, if you want to have the patience, you can actually add the 30 stations that you might actually watch to something called the favorites. You can turn your guide to just list favorites, and it'll only show you those 30 channels. And so if you want to do 100 channels, you can do that. But so yes, you can edit the guide down to limited, but you can't delete the channels from their system. You can just delete them from showing on your guide. So they're not technically deleted, they're just not showing on your guide.
In other words, if I want to put the guide, as I go through, it'll just skip over those channels.
Yes. Absolutely. He said if it just goes through, just go to those channels, and that's correct.
Thank you.
Next name.
Judy Silver here.
Hi.
Hi.
The same one that goes over there?
Yeah.
Okay.
You mentioned there's a 5-day period when they're porting the phone number from AT&T to Comcast for our landline. Does that mean that we will not have any landline service for that phone period?
What a great question. The question is if there's a 5 to 7 day gap between ordering your service and having it installed with Comcast, will I lose my current home phone? How many think they will lose their home phone? How many don't think they will? Now raise your hand if you don't think you're going to lose your phone. That is 100% correct. You do not lose your phone until the install guy actually comes and connects the wires and sets you up and good to go. At that point, it becomes a Comcast phone line and not a U-verse phone line. Great question.
You mentioned something up there, MLB innings through Comcast. I get my baseball through MLB.com. I pay them directly.
I think it's the same thing.
It's the same thing? It's cheaper to pay it through them.
His question was, he buys a subscription to the National Baseball League's games. I got, mine is different?
Yeah.
I don't know. Well,
I have an app on my smartphone. You can be able to get that on here.
It's different.
Okay, Mike says it's different. The question was, Anna, trust me, all I know is that some of the extra sports packages are available so you don't have to have a separate appliance or go to your computer. You'll have to wait to see when the time comes what level of service that has. If it's good enough for you, great. If it's not good enough, then you'll have to do what you're doing now. But you do have some
options. I mean, I don't mind getting it. If I get it myself to MLB.com, now I have an app on my smartphone. I pay for it. Would I be able to do that?
Yes.
This is not going to stop that. This is only trying to make it more convenient so you don't have to have an app on your smartphone. This means you can go to your box and just say MLB innings.
Well, but it'll get you right to it. But it's not the same thing.
That I don't understand.
That's speaking of phones.
Sure.
Theo IP phones that currently exist. Will they just switch over to Comcast? Or is Comcast phone going to be actually a VIOP system? I have Vonage now.
The question is Comcast actually a VOIP system? I have Vonage too. Just like U-verse is a VoIP system. So yes, VoIP will transfer from one VoIP carrier to another, so the phones will be unrelated to anything that you can think of. It's the same issue. Nothing's going to change. There is one issue that will change. How many of you have alarm systems that work? Therefore, when the agent leaves, make sure you test your alarm and then it rings the alarm company. They are not responsible for wiring an alarm system where you currently don't have a connection to the monitor. But we'll talk about that more. So if you want to, maybe they'll do it, maybe they won't. But remember, their job is to put a phone line in there and just make sure it works. If it's not working, it's not their job to fix it.
If it works now, Jason, it will work then. Because they're using the same thing.
If it works now, it will work then. If it's not working now, chances are it's not going to work then.
You got it. Jason, I need a little more clarification about the email. Many of us have AT&T emails. So can we still keep it?
The question is about AT&T email. Yes. I've gotten confirmation 5 times that you keep your AT&T email. I say, go forward with caution, because AT&T could yank that service at any point in time. Right now, they've chosen not to do it.
Can I just interject on that note that because the forms now for the new phone book are going to be sent out within the next couple of weeks, before you fill that form out and return it to the office, if you plan to change your email account, do it and put the new email address down on the form so the phone directories will be up to date. That is, if you want to include your email address in the phone, in the new phone directory. So change your email address before you complete that form and put the new email address on that form.
Jason, one more thing on emails. I had Verizon for my service in Virginia before we came down here, and I had Verizon email for a very long time. We kept it after we came down here. They allowed us to keep it, and then all of a sudden we got a letter saying they no longer supported it, and it was gone. So that's the reason I think you said not to do that.
Correct. Thank you for that.
Jason, I have one more question on the emails. You did not say that we need a separate email for our Comcast account. If we presently have a Gmail or a Hotmail, we can use that for our Comcast account. Is that correct?
No, that is not correct. The way I understand it, when you call Comcast, the question is, will you have a Comcast email as a control account for your Comcast account, just like FPNL requires an account, UVerse requires an account, your credit cards require a username. For Comcast account control, you're probably going to have a Comcast email address. That's just for controlling your Comcast account. Great question. And thank you all. Next.
What will the initial or the rest of the digging take place on Francisco Bend, Lake Water Main Bridge?
As far as I know, they are almost done. It's about 2 or 3 days and they're out of Francisco Bend. Okay. And then they're going to finish there. And then they'll be basically done by the end of next week. All right. The person who comes to hook everything up in your house, is that the same person you can go to and can he explain everything, or is that somebody else? In other words, when the guy comes and puts everything in, now we'll have questions about how it operates. Is that a different person, or is that the same person?
That's a great question.
When the installer comes in, what is he or she going to do? Other than setting up your equipment, making sure your internet works, your alarm works, they will spend a few minutes of time with you explaining how things work. That's one of the values of having that. We'll also have on-site meetings. You can come to that. There's also the Xfinity store next to Frank's Theater, next to Lucille's. I don't know if anybody's aware of that, but there's a Comcast store right next to Lucille's at Frank's Marketplace. You can go in there and ask questions. You remember I was talking about YouTube? You can go right onto YouTube and ask a lot of questions. Yes. But remember, here's the other thing. The installation will probably take 2 to 3 hours. Just like we did last time with UVerse. Just imagine this is a UVerse replacement. You got to give them access to your boxes. You got to give them access to your wall unit. All the stuff that we did in the past is the same, except we now have it more complicated because back in the day, nobody had these many boxes. Nobody had the internet all set up. So it's a much more complicated exchange. But yes, they will educate you to the best they can, and then we'll have follow-up training, and there will be meetings.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yes, ma'am.
All the little green men who are camping on everybody's lawns. What else with that? What are they saying there?
I don't need to be impolite, but that is a ridiculously silly question.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am, it is. We've covered it 150 times. How do you think they're distributing information from your house to your neighbors to some? Now, are you talking about the old ones or the new ones?
There's a house on my street.
Not relevant question. Which box
green.
Is on?
They're
all green.
The old one next to me.
Have you not been listening to anything that's been done in the last 5 months? I'm sorry to bother you, but I'm going to go the other way. I'm going to answer your question directly, but I think it's very inappropriate. We've already talked about this 27 times. The new green boxes are plastic, small, squat. They are the ones that are required to distribute fiber to every house. The long cylinder ones are AT&T. They're not going anywhere because AT&T is still allowed to distribute information to the community. Some people may want another AT&T phone. Some people may want to go with DirecTV. So AT&T is not going there. The square metal boxes from Comcast, they have the old coax in them. They will be removed probably in the first quarter of 18 once everybody is lit and wired because they will lose service. So those boxes are not going anywhere. I can't answer which box you're talking about, but two boxes will remain. Comcast box and an AT&T box. And the third box is some people have electrical boxes on their yard. So some people have three boxes.
I'll take a picture and I'll send it to you and you'll tell me what they are.
What color is it?
They're all the same color.
Okay.
They're just different sizes and shapes.
Ask your neighbors, I'll be willing to bet you, but yes, send me a picture and I'll tell you what they are. But the small box is Comcast. The one that's a little taller is Comcast, and the taller one is AT&T.
Why do we have one?
Yeah, I've got one around the community. I can't tell you if that's on your yard.
And the
And honestly, Jason, I appreciate all your incredible work.
Thank you. The committee did it. Well, thank you.
But I don't think I'm the only one who's wondering about.
Well, you know what? I'm not even going to deal with it because we no problem. I'll be happy to answer your question because it's a legitimate question. I'm confused that we haven't covered that before.
Any progress on the wireless set-top box?
Question is a wireless set-top box. Remember I told you I have a secret that Comcast doesn't know nothing about? If you attend the meeting that we're going to have this Sunday. Not this Sunday, but it's today. Monday, I lost the week. This Sunday at 7 to 9 p.m., we are going to have a more involved Comcast meeting. It will not be an install meeting. It will be a question and answer. It will be a question and answer meeting. And I will show you a trick that Comcast will not tell you how to deal with the wireless boxes. And now to answer the other question on the wireless boxes, the wireless boxes are not ever present like they are with UVerse. It took UVerse 4 years to get wireless boxes. Comcast is just coming out with them. They may have a few available, but for the most part, I'll show you a trick and you're going to laugh. Yes, ma'am.
Jason, AT&T has given us wonderful service.
I'll repeat the question.
AT&T has given us wonderful service. I understand from a lot of communities that have Comcast that the service is terrible. What arrangements have been made for service?
Question is, Comcast service sucks and AT&T is spectacular. What arrangements have been made to make sure that Comcast service is good? Truth of the matter is, both level of services have improved dramatically in the last 4 years. Comcast has now given us a dedicated bulk service center for answering calls. They're stateside, they're in Fort Myers, and they're in Jacksonville. I'm anticipating that because the conduit to the house and the fiber in the wall and the ground ending to the wall, that the ability of landscapers to cut through the conduit is nil, that the lawnmowers will not knock over the boxes and disconnect most of the boxes. That's been the big part of customer service. For the most part, if my service goes out because a box at the main office goes out, a whole bunch of people are going out and there's nothing we can do about it. So regularly, we have checked it out and their service has gotten better and hopefully the bulks, to be honest, hopefully you won't need them much. Because from what I can tell, the fiber is highly reliable. But it's a great question. Yes, sir.
This is the last question. Will Comcast do any wiring inside the house to hardwire the coaxial from room to room that we have AT&T wireless boxes right now?
It depends. Every house already has a coax in most rooms. I don't know if you've ever looked. Are you an original owner?
No.
Okay. As an original owner, we chose where the coaxes went in each room. So in my particular model,
they should be there.
They're all there. My particular model, there's only one room in my house that does not have a coax in that room. So as an interim measure, if they can't get it to work, they may have to run around the baseboard to the other side, or if they can snake it. But they will do their best to get you service where you want it. So the question is about wiring. Good question. Yes, ma'am.
Hi, Diane Gilberti. I have some confusion, a lot of confusion, but the one that I have right now is Joe has a Comcast email. Comcast. How does that work with the other email that you're talking about? I have confusion about two separate things. I don't understand.
The question is, Joe has a Comcast email called joejoberti@comcast.net. He can keep that because he's not going to be a Comcast subscriber. That's his normal email. I highly recommend he dump it. You just heard what happened to Buzz. He was a Verizon.net subscriber. Verizon calls him up one day and says, guess what? That email is toast. Better get a new email. So I highly suggest you get Hotmail, Gmail, MSN. You're welcome. With that, Karen, we're done.